A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
It's not tuned. It's not the way you intend it to be. So here we have NewTone. So here in NewTone, we have the sound.
A, B, C, D, E.
I'm using control and scrolling up and then middle click to click and move around. It's way different than the melody shown in the piano roll. So if I hit F7 for the piano roll, notice. Here it's C sharp, and then up here, like almost on, what is that, F sharp, like halfway there. And look at the vocal here. A, B, it's like not even on the C note. See here, it's on C note, because we put it there. This is not C note, so right off the bat,
A, B, C.
You just want to.
A, B, C.
As you've seen right here, you could take the track, the audio clip right here, when it shows you the up and down, click it and then move up and down.
A, B, C, D.
It does sound very unnatural, but you know, that's the thing about having to adjust the sound. It may change up how it sounds. You could even double click. So let me find a spot. How about for this, for example? We could double click it. And it'll give us more variation or more little functions here. See, we have this where we could change up the way the intro curve, like waveform piece sounds. Yeah, fade it. See how it moves all that. This little doodad here is something with the format, as you see when I'm moving it up and down. This is to change the timbre of your sound. So I'm gonna hit play.
G, G.
Now look at this weird sound.
G, G. G,
so that's not bad.
F, G.
And there's more functions like the variation here. Just this, you can't really see it there, but it has to do with the wave right here, the way this is variating. Again, there's a, what you call it, universal little speed spot for it. Let's say, for example, you want to stretch out the way the G is because it cuts off so early.
G.
You want to make it longer or something. And you're not able to move it because it's a whole block, even this little empty space. There is a way to cut it out. And right here, this little cut mode, bam. Just click where you want to cut. Bam. Click it. Little arrowhead. Drag it out. It's going to sound weird.
FG.
Okay, that's not that bad. Control, scroll down. Alt is to do up and down like this. I'm just mentioning this because everybody, you know, always hit up the comments. How do you do that? Here's another great example. We could try and do this. P, like weird.
L-M-N-O-P.
Yeah, P. After you're done changing the pitch, making it how you want it, and, you know, going over, playing it back.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, N, Z, W.
Okay, so as you heard, that's how it sounds when it is, you know, edited up. Once you are done and you're content with the sound, you could do couple of things. I'll show you examples. You could go to Edison. Let me go ahead and delete this. You could do the drag and drop by clicking this little button here that says drag selection. You could drag it, drop it in Edison.
A, B,
and go here.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Or you could even put it in the playlist, like doing so. Drag and drop. And let me big that up for you. And here it is. The whole track. And you can mute that by right alt and then click
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
It's better than before, I'll tell you that.
A, B, C, D.
Ah, no.